offended this audacious bill by ignoring his advice, and now I've fallen out with two of his musketeers. I must acquire more finesse. Perhaps I can mock myself on Aramid.
My dear Albany.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning, my lord.
I believe this is your handkerchief.
What a divine sight, Madame de... Madame de Aguillon? No, too much muscle.
Ah, suspicion of enmity, Madame de Chivet.
And Venetian lace.
Look at this delicate way.
The gentleman's mistaken. I have my handkerchief right here.
Your blushing owl. Flowers in springtime bloom on her head.
And what else follows as the artist's land?
It's a billionaire.
Fight with us, you can't fight against us.
We'll make you an honorary musketeer, okay? Now tell me, Prince.
You're a brave man.
You are all brave
men. I'm proud of you. Can't approve officially, of course. But when it comes to a war, I expect you all to bury the hatchet. And should you choose a quiet corner, your commander and I will look the other way. Your Majesty.
Trebill, I think I'll satisfy myself with a bit of your mid-year. I feel 10 years from you.
How shall I ever spend all this?
Ah, that won't last long in Paris. Find yourself a rich mistress and plan for the future.
First things first, my dear fellow. I'm yourself a servant to look after your clothes.
No, gentlemen, first we must get a case of wine and have a damn good meal. Gentlemen,
I'm not very experienced in these matters. I'd be most grateful for your help. Perhaps we can go out to dinner this evening.
All for one man.
And one.
Four. All.
I don't think you will follow. Thank you, Your Grace. I'll bring the Queen. Monsieur Laporte, the Duke of Buckingham is here.
Your Grace.
I am pleased to see you, Laporte.
Her Majesty the Queen!
You must have learned by now that I never wrote the letter that brought you to Paris.
I have, Anne, but it was foolish to believe that Margot could stop him. But love isn't rational.
I gave up the journey because I might see you.
At the risk of your life, Constance's life, my reputation, the only reason I'm seeing you is to tell you must never meet again. It's sacrilege to struggle against the laws of God.
Isn't it sacrilege to separate two hearts that God has meant for each other?
I never said I loved you.
At least you've never denied it. And in 3 years, this is only our fourth meeting. I've only once, for a few moments, been alone with you. In the garden at the end.
Talk about anything.
You remember it. While the stars were out, the air was warm, heavy with the scent of flowers. You held my arm as we walked along the avenues, and when you told me of the troubles in your life, you bent your head, and your hair, you brushed my cheek. And I swear, not me like that.
Perhaps that evening. But let me remind you of the sequel. Cardinal aroused the king's suspicions. My friends were exiled, and when you tried to return to France,
the door was slammed in my face. But France will pay for the king's jealousy. And if I can't see you, Anne, at least you'll hear of me every day. What do you think of planning an expedition for a league of Protestants at La Rochelle? The war will lead to peace. The peace shall require a negotiator. And I shall ride from Paris again. But this time, it's conquering. Thousands may die, but I will see you again.
You mustn't do such things for my sake. I am Queen of France.
If you were a queen, would you love me?
I didn't say that.
If it's an illusion, Anne, let me live in it. Perhaps die. I've had terrible dreams lately.
I had a dream last night. I saw you lying, bleeding.
With an eye, in my left side.
How do you know? I only told God in my prayers.
Could God send us the same dreams unless we love each other?
Leave me now. I can't decide whether I love you or not. But I do know that I will never break my marriage vow. And that your love must not harm my country.
I declare war on the entire continent to get one more glimpse at your face.
I'll give you something to remember me by. Take these diamonds. They're the most precious jewels I have. They were given to me by the king on behalf of the people of France. While they're in your possession, let them be a pledge that you will keep peace between France and England. Constance.
Marvel to the end, Your Majesty. I shall keep my word.
Poets must praise her now as lover's son.
That D'Artagnan is just about right.
fellow Paul. Not an exceptionally good year, but sound line nonetheless. Let's see what Grimo has found for us now. What you got here, Grimo?
Ah,
a burgundy. Chateau de Rosemont. First, the color. Now, note. Take a sip. Slow it around in your palate. Slowly. Take your time. Savor it. Don't worry about spitting it out. Go ahead and swallow it. Not a bad beer, but you could use another couple of years to get that.
Excellent tactics, Arcane, catching him above the grocers.
It was quite accidental.
Well, then you have the true instincts of the musketeer, which is far more important. Aramaid, we rather the social this evening.
I'm sorry, D'Artagnan. My publishers are pressing me, and I'm 2 weeks behind in my prayers.
Does Grimaud ever misunderstand you?
Very rarely, but I know he's with him when he does. Not to mention, I do enjoy the silence when I'm out
in the park. Get in there! Oh, D'Artagnan, I found you, sir. His name is,
Planchet.
I found a little over a bridge, speaking of water. That suggested a harmless, philosophical nature. I engaged him on the spot, 30 sous a day. You can stop by having him brush your clothes. Martella can do something with him, and I'll shake things in tomorrow.
Make yourself at home, Planchet.
I thought I was to serve this gentleman.
What an absurd idea! Drunk like a man who has no servant. I shouldn't stand for any insolence of that sort, D'Artagnan.
Planchet, I forbid you to leave my service without permission. I know I'm going to be extremely successful, and I'm far too considerate to let you miss such a chance.
Bravo, D'Artagnan.
Much obliged, sir. Very thoughtful, I'm sure.
And now to dinner. Planchet, serve the pate. Bravo. Face those partridges, please.
Ah, I think you quite right. Though I don't see any colors. I'll have someone to start with, I shall.
For what is to cookery, as the sonnet is to poetry? That, D'Artagnan, is a bon mot. A bon mot is a form you should master, D'Artagnan. It seasons one's conversation. You've read Montaigne, of course.
Not a word.
But he's from Gascony. My dear fellow, this is appalling. I shall have a tinkle in hand. Montaigne for thought, Rosard for passion, and
Rene for life.
Aha, St. Augustine for your soul. You shall find it essential to attend the right church. I myself hear mass at La Madeleine. All the best people go there, and all the young men and women.
D'Artagnan, listen to Aramaid when it comes to things in literature. Listen to me when it comes to women. Use them if you must, but don't get caught in their clutches. Discard them when you're done with them.
Planchet!
Come in. Good evening, Mr. D'Artagnan. Gentlemen, sorry to disturb you at table.
Haven't I seen you somewhere before?
Just this morning, sir. I own a grocery on the ground floor. You asked me if you could rent this apartment, which reminds me, you have not paid the rent.
I would give him a suit, D'Artagnan, until he burnishes the place properly. Not fit for a gentleman. No sign of a bookcase.
Well, what do you want?
It's my wife, sir. She's been abducted.
Your wife?
She's only 20. I married her last year. Miserable dowry to scrape together for her. But she's a pretty little thing. Her godfather is the Queen's valet.
Monsieur Laporte.
That's right. He got her a job at court as a lady in waiting. She gets to come home once a week, so I went to meet her. You have to keep an eye on these young wives, you know. And that's when Monsieur Laporte told me, abducted!
But who
you when your usefulness has been exhausted. If you value your life, don't look for her.
That sounds serious, but it is only a threat.
I find threats like that very persuasive. Just a glimpse of the Bastille turns my stomach. But you are associated with the Musketeers. I thought you might be interested in taking on the Cardinal's men. I forget about the rent.
Are you rich?
I get by, sir. Years of hard work and self-denial.
Well,
would 50 crowns interest you?
That's more like it.
Then you'll do it?
Fetch the money, and I'll make a plan.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
There is an air of mystery about this business that has its attractions. But is it worth risking our four heads for 50 crowns?
A woman is in danger. A young, beautiful woman. Abducted. Tortured, perhaps. And all for serving her mistress faithfully.
And the woman was made for man's destruction.
Besides, she's only a shopkeeper's wife.
But she serves the queen. Will we stand either by, or the cardinal snuffs out all of the queen's friends?
I wish she wasn't so enchanted by our enemies.
Personally, I'd like to take the Duke of Buckingham by the hand and lead him straight to the queen, just to spite the cardinal.
Help! 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 The cardinal's men, they've come to arrest me.
Just a moment, Porthos. Let's use our heads.
What you promised the old boy?
D'Artagnan is the most intelligent. I think we should listen to him.
Come in, gentlemen. Come in. Welcome to my apartment. We are all loyal to the king and the cardinal.
You won't prevent us carrying out the cardinal's orders?
On the contrary, we'll give you any assistance you need.
Let's take a man each.
Quietly, no smoke.
You promised to help me.
We can only help you if we stay free. If we take your side now, they'll arrest us too. Here he is, gentlemen. He's been pestering me about my rent. Serves you right, you stingy old goat. The spell on the Bastille will teach you some respect.
You promised you'd help me.
Hold on to him as long as you can, gentlemen. Monsieur Picard, a glass of wine.
With pleasure.
Then we'll drink to your health.
And to poor Monsieur Giuseppe.
And to the king. And the cardinal.
To the king.
This is monstrous! Musketeers to see him paralyzed! Will the man move off the town as Cardinal by the Cardinal's henchmen?
Athos, I have never heard Porthos calling the moon so, and I agree with him. D'Artagnan, you're a great man!
Well, be damned! Athos, you agree with what D'Artagnan's done?
I agree with him, and I congratulate him for it.
I don't follow.
Porthos, you used to be known as the Three Inseparables.
And now, we are four! So hold out your hands and swear. All for one, and one for all!
Gentlemen, from this moment, we are at war with the Cardinal.
So, Madame Monsieur brought Buckingham to the Louvre.
I know she did.
And you certainly took the diamonds with her.
Certainly, Your Eminence.
Thank you, Dona Estefania, for your help. You won't find me ungrateful.
Your Eminence.
Your Eminence, a message has arrived for you. Fight the kitchen. Your Eminence, the Comte de Rochefort is here.
Admit him. The innkeeper down the end tells me the Buckingham rode by at dawn, headed for Calais.
Can't be stopped.
He should have never been allowed to leave Paris. But I know the conviction in England. Do you have a monsieur?
The husband's outside.
The wife?
Escaped.
Rochefort? My patience is exhaustible.
I'm sure your Eminence is genius.
Will cover up his agent's incompetence?
I hope so, Lord. I hope so.
There's a great deal at stake here. That queen is a perpetual menace to the safety of France. She'll beckon the Bourbons across the Pyrenees with one hand, and Buckingham across the Channel with the other. Find out if she's written any letters today, and send in this Bonacieux creature.
Bring in Bonacieux.
Bonacieux! Oh, and Rochefort, ask Milady to come see me.
Rochefort, that's the man who's abducted my wife this morning. Oh, no, I am mistaken with your evidence. No resemblance at all.
Why? Bonacieux, the charge against you is treason. You've spent one night in the Bastille. You're a rock there.
Your Eminence, it has nothing to do with me. My wife said the Cardinal had Lord Buckingham here to ruin the Queen.
She told you that?
Yes, Your Eminence. But I scolded her very severely. I said the Cardinal would never
dream of your tongue. You're an imbecile.
That's just what she said.
I need your help, my dear Monsieur. Your wife has left custody. I want you to go home and wait for her. She may suspect the trap, you can reassure her. Then my man will bring her to me and I will give her some fatherly advice.
Please tell her to stay out of mischief, Your Eminence. She won't listen to me.
Well, she'll be in good hands. Oh, and I hope you don't hold your knight in the steel against me, Monsieur.
No, no.
And if you come across any information, please get in touch with me. I've been well for loyal service. Be good. Let's go to Mr. Bonacieux home. Ah, lady, how refreshing to deal with someone of intelligence. But no sooner do I enjoy the pleasure of your coming than I must set you off.
Do you intend to extract the full crown of flesh, Your Eminence?
I always keep my word, my lady. The chateau de la Fere will be yours.
But when will I be free to enjoy it?
My lady, you agree to my terms. I'd be sorry to see you go back on that. I've enjoyed working with you.
And I would be to deny you any pleasure.
So, here's your safe conduct in. Believe tonight. Get yourself invited to the next ball the Duke of Buckingham attends. He'll be wearing a set of 12 diamonds. Cut off two of them and bring them to me immediately. Here's a change of plans and call the board for great instructions.
Your Eminence, the Duke of Buckingham guards me as an enemy. It won't be easy to get close to him.
The Duke's appetites are fierce. You have made colder than your victims.
Is anyone home?
I am, my dear. I've been waiting for you. Are you alone?
Of course, I'm quite alone. What a silly question.
I wanted to see you last night. I'm sure the port told me. Abducted.
Yes, I managed to escape.
What did they want?
Mind your own business. Do you think I risk you blurting out the Queen's secret?
Would you rather discuss it with the Cardinal?
Who are you? Who is this man? I'm Madame Bonacieux. I'm mistress of this house. I serve the Queen.
You may find that you serve the King and the Cardinal quite badly, having served the Queen so well.
No! Help! Help!
Molesting scoundrel! My chair! My sword!
Where are you going? You get yourself killed!
D'Artagnan! Betrayal!
be safer. My friends will be here soon. Planchette!
Yes, sir?
Don't warn Alice!
You realize you're risking your life.
Madame, God has sent me to watch over you.
I'm always at the king's service, and I'm always at yours.
Still in check, Your Majesty.
So I am.
John, if you were there, my bishop makes your queen.
But then you'd have to sacrifice a knight.
How is that on the two sacks, by the way?
Still the sling, I see.
Quite the swordsman, that young D'Artagnan.
Let's hope he proves as brave in war as he does in private brawl.
What are you hinting at?
Check yourself.
That the English may land at La Rochelle, and then we will have a full-scale campaign on our hands. Check, Your Majesty. And mates. So, Buckingham was in France last week.
Buckingham? What's he coming to?
Your guess is as good as mine. Some sort of intrigue, no doubt, with the Protestants of La Rochelle or with the agents of Spain.
She's been deceiving me, hasn't she?
What a vile accusation, sire. The Queen is virtue personified. All of France knows how much the Queen loves Your Majesty.
Women are notoriously weak, Monseigneur, as your hours of confessional must have taught you. And I consider myself a better judge of the Queen's affections than either you or France.
Well, I still maintain the Duke of Buckingham was just making political history.
And I believe his mission was more personal. But we'll get to the bottom of it. And if the Queen is guilty, then she better take to her knees. She'll need all the help she can muster.
I find the mere accusation of such a crime quite repugnant. But if Your Majesty insists, I suppose we must consider it. Donna Stefania did inform me she's been writing letters all day.
To her love, of course. We must read them.
How can we possibly obtain them? It's hardly a simple task for Your Majesty, or for myself, for that matter.
Conduct the search. First her apartments, then her person.
We are discussing Anne of Austria, Queen of France.
If she has left her position, she will be treated as she deserves. Have it done.
Very well, Your Majesty. Just that. Search the Queen's apartment for documents. And inform the Queen, His Majesty requests her presence.
Has she deceived me?
I believe she has been intriguing against Your Majesty's state, but not Your Honor.
Against both. She's never loved me. And she's been assaulted by that Machinelle. Where did they meet this time?
But there was no meeting.
You seem quite familiar with Buckingham's movements, Monseigneur. They would inquire why he didn't have the man arrested.
Arrest the King of England's chief minister? Oh, that would cause an international scandal. And suppose Your Majesty's suspicions prove true. You would be the laughingstock of Europe.
Her Majesty the Queen!
Peremptory summons for this hour of night, sire. What does this man's search mean? Do you think my apartment hides something that I would be ashamed to give you?
I cannot tell you what I think or do not think until I choose, madame. But I have reason to believe that you have written a letter to it, and it is not in your writing box. I should like to read it.
Madam, did you write a letter tonight?
I have, Monseigneur. It's here.
You, sir? The letter.
You heard his eminence. You must be bolder.
Monseigneur, the Queen does not like you. She asks her brother, the King of Spain, to declare war and make your dismissal a condition of peace. Madame, can you kindly withdraw for a few moments? I have an important matter of politics to discuss.
Yes, sire.
Well, Monseigneur, you were right.
see what place my opponents have prepared to go. As I've mentioned many times, my health has suffered. I'm very willing to hand over the burdens of office to someone else.
I understand you perfectly, Monsignor, and I will not hear of it. But I truly appreciate the difficulties of your position. Everyone implicated in this letter will be punished, including the Queen.
God forbid the Queen should suffer on my account. She looks on me as an enemy, I know, even though I've often defended her against you. Now, if she had been unfaithful, that would be something else, and I would recommend and be the first to recommend that she be condemned. But she has not proved herself to be a loving wife. And your Majesty has been quite harsh with her. It would be a graceful gesture if you healed the breach.
I ask for her pardon?
Sire, it is blessed to forgive. Do something to give her pleasure. You know how much she enjoys dancing. Hold a ball in her honor.
You know how such entertainments bore me.
Well, then she'll be all the more grateful.
Madam, I would like to speak with you.
Yes, sire.
It has occurred to me that life at the court has been rather tedious these past few months. All the cardinal's fault, of course, pestering me all days and nights with affairs of state. That's why I've decided we should have a little celebration. In fact, I've arranged for a gala ball a week from Saturday. What do you say to that, madam?
That pleases me. I haven't had time to dance in months.
Or an opportunity to wear the diamonds your Majesty was given by the nation.
An excellent suggestion, Monsignor. You haven't worn them since your birthday. Do you hear, madam?
Yes, sire.
You will attend my ball.
Yes, sire.
You will wear the diamonds?
Yes, sire.
Thank you, madam. That's all I need to say to you. Good night.
I've been betrayed. The cardinal of everything.
Your Majesty, a message from the Nautilus of Steels.
Who brought it?
The condemned musketeer. He's still at the gate. Fear I have to wait?
Yes.
Your Majesty, someone must go to the Duke. We still have a chance.
We may not all get that. So
So it's a campaign?
If I'm risking my skin, I prefer to know why.
Does the king give you reason?
Well, Ken, you're quite right. We do have 2 weeks leave and 200 crowns. Let's say we go get ourselves killed.
Let's say, saddle the horses.
But we have a big plan. Where are we heading for?
Helen.
Well, here's my advice. 4 men lying together look highly suspicious. I'll travel and be able to know. Athos will head up an hour later and head for Amiens. Aramis and Noyon. D'Artagnan will disguise himself as Planchet and head up an hour later for a castle.
Wait. Secret kingdom. The inevitably sold by servants. This doesn't make any sense.
Porthos' whole plan is impractical. Look, I've been entrusted with a sealed letter from the Duke of Buckingham. And if I'm to be killed, then one of you must take it, and so on. As long as one of us makes it, the queen will be safe.
That's a great idea. We should leave Paris separately. We'll meet in Chantilly, at the shoulder of mutton.
But first, we must escort Constance to the Louvre.
Come on.
enemies.
Sometimes we try to avoid what we're truly drawn to.
You make up a quarrel so beautifully, my dear.
We must fall against you.
Shall I stop?
No, not yet. We haven't begun the reconciliation. Come.
We are safe, proud as a Scotsman. We stay proud as a
Gascons are the Scots of France.
Under orders to sail for La Rochelle.
I intend to
Monsieur? She's in my gym.
There it is.
Make sure she stays there. Ask for her admirer. And she sent Colon at his lodging. It's time that young Gaston came to work with me.
Now, D'Artagnan, the triumphant return is obviously connected with the Queen's delight and the cargo's humiliation.
Can the cargo know that I've been in London?
London? Never. Oh. And then is that how you came by that diamond shining like a lighthouse on your finger?
Sir, this was a gift from the Queen of France.
So, money is anonymous. The pedigree of that ring could hang you.
Sell a ring given to me by the Queen? No, never.
Oh, D'Artagnan, the ring could get you in big trouble with the cardinal. He has a long memory. At least have the sense to turn it inwards. There's a long memory and a longer arm, as you discovered. Which reminds me, where are your three companions?
I left them on the road.
Go find them and, well, Carter hunts for you in Paris. We leave march on La Rochelle within the week.
But, sir, I must look after my mistress.
Oh, come. Young D'Artagnan, it's by the woman that man first fell. Go, tonight.
Monsieur Giuseppe.
The very man. Oh, you with all milk and honey, monsieur. I have come on his eminence's behalf, who sends his compliments and would be vastly obliged if Monsieur D'Artagnan would pay a visit to him at the Palais Royal.
And how did you reply?
I told him you were out, monsieur, as you could see for himself. Where did he go? Asked Monsieur Giuseppe. To Gaspignard, replied. To see his aged father before leaving the war. You see, since I am not a gentleman, I thought I might be permitted to lie.
Planchet, you almost told the truth. We leave in 10 minutes. Saddle the horses.
Are we to be chopped and peppered all over again?
Grab your musket, your pistols, and your knife.
You see, just like ourselves.
Relax, Fletcher. This is a pleasure experience.
Oh, just like the one last week? When it rained musket balls and man traps?
Are you afraid, Fletcher?
Afraid?
First class rabbit stew.
What about your mistress?
Vanitas vanitatum, usum lemens nomen.
In that case, I shall have to burn this letter.
What letter?
A letter left in your lodgings from some broken-hearted girl, Madame de Chevreuse's chambermaid, perhaps. Stole a sheet of scented paper and wrote her missive with the Duchess's coronet.
Give it to me.
Well, I must have lost it. But as you say, Arthur,
Don't break your heart over a woman, D'Artagnan.
That is easy enough to say,
but you have never been in one.
That is true. I have never been in love.
Then you should show some kind of sympathy for those of us who are.
D'Artagnan, you have all of my sympathy. She is left when you still believe that she loves you. Let me tell you a story about love that will change your mind about women.
Is it about you?
No. It's about a friend of mine. The Comte de la Fleur. His estate is not very far from here, actually. When he was 25, he married a beautiful girl of 16. She had come to the country with her brother, a priest. And she was so beautiful, and he was so devout, nobody ever bothered to find out where they had come from. And my friend the cop, he could have seduced her. But instead, he exercised the rights of the Lord of the estate. She captivated him. The fool that he was, he married her.
But he did love her.
He loved her only a way that a man can love his wife. He gave her his name and his lands, made her first lady of the province. Then one day they went out hunting. And she had a great fall. She fainted. And he knelt down to loosen her dress. And he pulled it from her shoulder. What do you think he found, D'Artagnan?
How can I tell?
The fleur de lis, branded on her shoulder by the common hangman. His angel was the devil. She robbed the church.
And what did he come?
He stripped the dress from her that he had given her. He bound her hands behind her. He hanged her from the nearest tree.
A murder?
Some would say. There's a lesson to be learned in this, D'Artagnan. Enjoying wine? Love with your head, not with your heart. And this is what cured me, my friend, of beautiful women with long dark hair. D'Artagnan Moore, he's a good man. He cannot hold this liquor. Come on.
Madame, Monsieur D'Artagnan at the gate?
Ah, excellent news!
the Marquese. We are forced to make such rendezvous because of our husband's jealousy.
Ah, Monsieur Porte, you are a great favorite with the ladies.
Of course. With a physique like mine, I have my share of fortune.
Oh, God, how a man does forget.
Not so quickly as a woman, I fancy, madame. Weak and helpless, despaired of by surgeons, as they strangle my wounds and hunger at a mean tavern in Chantilly, with not one answer to my anguished letters.
Monsieur Porthos!
I, for whom your sake have
abandoned my
confidence, the Duchess did.
Don't torment me!
The Baroness did.
Oh, forgive me, Monsieur Porthos, forgive me! It was my husband. He forbade me to send the money. But I learned my lesson. Next occasion, all you need do is ask, and I dare say that you will find the strong box of an attorney's wife to be just as well filled as the silk purses of your precious maid.
Madame, you are rich that doubles the injury.
When I say well filled, you mustn't take me literally.
Madame, I see you are not truly repentant. I'm off to the wars, and something tells me I shall not return.
Oh, be merciful! Don't talk like that!
I do, madame, I do. From now until the time of our departure, I shall be fully occupied with collecting my equipment. I thought I had a friend in Paris, but I see I was sadly mistaken.
God, you have one, Monsieur Porthos. You have one. Come to my house tomorrow and be discreet. My husband still has all his wits about him for his 70 years.
70? That's a great age.
As you say, Monsieur, I could be a widow any day now. And fortunately, everything would go to me.
Ah, Madame Coconut, you are a woman to be reckoned with.
Adieu, my angel.
Adieu.
Sometimes.
is the son of the Spanish ambassador.
Lieutenant, this lady of yours seems to be an infamous creature. You may have been wrong to deceive her. She could prove a terrible enemy.
You admire my ring?
I do. It reminds me of a family jewel of my own. Have you sold the Queen's diamonds then?
No, this was a gift from the Duchess that I met last night.
Monsieur, you must help me. The lady has sent me to the Comte de Rose to find out when he can see her again. I must bring her an answer.
D'Artagnan, renounce that woman.
You're right, Alex. I shall.
Do not rely on me, madame. Since our last meeting, I have had a great deal of these affairs to do. When your turn comes around again, I will let you know. It is beautiful, isn't it?
It is. It's magnificent. It's amazing that two stones can be so similar. D'Artagnan, please, turn it inward. It brings back too many painful memories.
Then I shall sell it. Purchase our equipment. A family jewel, you said.
I must have been mistaken.
And you sold it.
Well, no, I gave it away in the red glove. That's the way you received yours.
Madame, come on board. Impossible that a gentleman would write such a letter. Why are you pawing? I fear the lady might faint. I faint? What do you take me for? When I'm insulted, I avenge myself. Now, let's start him and tell him to bring his sword. And now that I've satisfied you with the of my love, you must satisfy me that I'm yours. By tomorrow, come to the house.
But suppose the Comte de Lourdes isn't as guilty as you presume.
Excuse me.
I shall try. Because I do have the assurance of your love, don't I?
Completely. Go on.
Well, my adorable mistress, I have a small confession to make. And because I have assurance of your love, I can dare to tell you. You kept an assignation with the Comte de Lourdes 2 nights ago.
That is not true.
Don't lie, my dear. I was there. The Comte de Lourdes of Thursday and the D'Artagnan of today are one and the same. The fleur-de-lis!
You're the only man alive who knows my secret, and you'll die with it!
Hey!
D'Artagnan! Scoundrel! Deceiver!
I am assuming the command of the siege, Rochefort. The essential is a part of the city is Buckingham's fleet. I propose to construct a dike from here to here and so blockade the arrows.
The Rochelaire obstinate reader means the mariners take all without being surrendered.
If they wish to die one by one of starvation, that is their affair. This is the last port of the French open to the English. Defeat of the English means humiliation for Buckingham.
Monsieur D'Artagnan,
you are D'Artagnan from Bayonne in Gascony?
Yes, sir.
The day after you were received by a great lady, whose valuable gift I know you preserve, I requested that you call upon her. You did not come.
I feared I had incurred your displeasure, Your Eminence.
I punish those who disobey my orders, not those who fulfill them. But I have a proposition to make to you then, and I make it to you now. I have a vacancy for an ensign in my guards. You accept it?
Your Eminence.
You refuse?
Your Eminence, my enemies, unhappily, are in your service. But my friends are in the Musketeers. I hope to one day be worthy of a place beside them.
So So be it, monsieur. But be vigilant in the pursuit of your loves and hates. I have protected you until this moment.
Your Eminence, so long as I act in honor, I ask you to remain neutral.
Young man, if on a future occasion I am able to repeat the offer I made today, I say if I am able, you have my word, I shall do so. Rochefort, has His Majesty arrived yet with the Musketeers?
They're not expected for tomorrow, Your Eminence.
Very well. Confirm our arrangements for tonight. I will speak with our agent at 10 at the Red Dove Club.
But your Eminence, we just saved the warden.
for unsavory and undesirable characters about. It's important that I not be disturbed, so I ask that you remain here as my escort. Bring more wine for the musketeer.
Yes, sir.
Have you rescued the cardinal's mistress or something?
After all, I may be rather like you, a soldier and a priest. Do you have any dice?
Yes, monsieur.
What about our council board?
We'll talk about that later.
Lady, our situation is critical. My situation is first, yours because you depend on me. While Michelle will last indefinitely with help from English, the king's patience will not. The drastic steps must be taken to stop the English fleet from sailing.
And what do you propose?
There is a small boat waiting at the mouth of the Chiron. Jussac will escort you there tonight. Then let the dawn tide himself towards me. And soon I will expect to hear about one of those strokes of fate that change the course of history.
Exactly.
Precisely.
Would you send me to eternal damnation?
You know I'm a man of God, but Buckingham has many enemies. It wouldn't be hard to find a copy.
My price will be high.
Name it.
First, my freedom from any further service. Second, the head of our family.
For what crime?
I will reveal what he has done to me, but I can provide ample evidence of his crimes against the city.
Agreed. When I see proof.
Third, a card plan signed by you for what I'm about to do.
It is by my order and for the good of the state that the bearer of this paper has done what has been done. Issue.
Out.
Tell the cardinal I'm going to scout. Catch up to it.
Jussac will be along shortly. When you get back to France, be sure to send your report. Then go to the convent at Bethune. Rochefort will meet your day. The lady, you hold our futures in your hands. I feel quite sure that you won't let us down. Oh, and if you find life irksome in the seclusion of your chateau, please call on me. I can always find employment for you. Where's Athos?
He's gone to reconnoitre the road back.
How have you passed the time?
I want more crowd on the locals.
Your horse, then, gentlemen. It's getting late.
No way. Where's the new yet? For the pleasure of seeing you again. Satan may have resurrected you, but he cannot wash the stains from your soul or the brand from your body. And bro, that was your name when your brother married us, yet you still want to play Papa's Dinner Flair.
What do you want?
Why do you know that I've been watching you? I know that you stole two medallions from Buckingham. You had Constance Bonacy abducted. And twice, you tried to have D'Artagnan killed. And for assassinating Buckingham, you've asked for D'Artagnan's head as payment.
It's you who are saving.
Perhaps. But Buckingham doesn't concern me. He's an Englishman. But D'Artagnan is my friend. And if you harm one hair on his head, that'd be the last crime you ever lived to commit.
He insulted me, and so will die for it.
Can a thing like you be insulted?
Perhaps, but he'll die for it. And that constant will serve him right out.
Give me the paper that the cardinal handed to you. You have 3 seconds, or I will blow your head off.
wounded my curse.
Piper, your fangs are there.
Landlord!
The lady is ready. You have your orders from the cardinal. The lady, your ship is waiting.
You won't stop me from praying to my Redeemer.
God forbid I prevent.
God forbid!
But because he obeys the law of God, poor man, he came to my bedding. I screamed and I fought, I even scratched his flesh with my own nail. But he laughed. He said, I have no use for Puritans, but pretty Puritan girls like you amuse me. And before I knew it, he placed a wet sponge over my knee. And I spat and. But I just couldn't stop a pain jerk from dribbling down my throat. I passed out, and when I woke up, I was in a bold bed, sprawled among silk sheets, and a voice rang in my ear. It said, my dear, you may deny me while you're awake, but you should see what you do when you're sleeping.
Oh, who was it?
For 2 weeks, he forced himself on me, every night. I would kill myself, but I was never allowed to mind.
Who did it?
Eventually, my guard took pity on me and carried me to safety. Nowhere in the world was I safe from that monster's lust and cruelty. Felt it? Soon after, two men broke into my apartment. They stripped and bound me, and the voice that I knew all so well said, you're a prostitute, and you'll be branded as a prostitute. Executioner, do your duty. And iron was plunged into my shoulder. I fainted from the smell of burning flesh. Look at my shoulder, Felton. See how this country rewards chastity?
The fool to leave!
The mark of England would have required a court of law, but who would question the mark of France?
Oh, God! Oh, God, forgive me! Forgive me, God!
For what?
For joining the prosecutors! Who did this to you so that I can avenge you?
Who else but the Antichrist himself?
Buckingham.
Lord, wake up!
The carriage is ready, John. These are the papers. They only need the Duke of Buckingham's signature. I shall join you in his headquarters.
And bon voyage, sister. I believe this promises to be your last and longest journey. Tell her that my eyes closed, looking upon her treasure.
punishes, but the cardinal punishes even more severe with offenses.
Poor madame, I understand now. I will make you my second refugee.
Who else are you hiding?
Such a sweet young lady. They called her Kitty. She's been involved in some intrigue before.
Can I see her? I feel such sympathy for her.
Of course, I'll catch her now.
If this is my Kitty, I'll tear her out.
The abbess said you'd like to see me, madam?
Yes, honey. I thought you might be lonely and perhaps we could help each other pass the time.
If only you'd come sooner. I've been here on my own for 3 weeks, and now you've arrived just as I'm about to leave.
You're leaving soon?
I hope and pray I am. I had this letter yesterday, saying my friends would soon be in Paris, and they come straight here.
And who are these gallant friends?
Perhaps you know them, madam. You must know so many people in Paris. They're musketeers. Porthos, Aramis, Athos, and...
Athos?
You know him?
Why, yes, they're a friend of his.
D'Artagnan? You know him too? Excuse me, madam, but in what capacity do you know him?
Why, as a friend.
You're not speaking the truth. You've been his mistress.
No, you're the mistress. You're Constance Monsieur, I know now. Don't deny it.
I am. But are we rivals?
No, the furthest thing from there. But surely the musketeers are at La Rochelle.
They should be, but nothing is impossible for my D'Artagnan. Could this be him?
Do you see him?
I can't tell. He's gone inside.
It must be someone from one of us.
How pale you look.
A gentleman to see the lady from Boulogne?
It's for you, madam. I'll retire.
Sure, but come back the moment he's gone.
I will.
My brave chevalier.
As charming as ever, lady. The cardinal has received your message, but send me to find out the details.
And no details to give. Buckingham is dead or wounded, the fleet has not sailed, and if I were to seek to inquire further, I would never meet you alone.
When did you arrive?
This morning, and I gave you no time. Constance is here to write this over. She expects D'Artagnan to spread this word. I can't say that.
Unfortunately, I have the troops' orders to collect this mattress and return to the cargo.
Take it with
you? Impossible, I'm afraid. The cardinal has ordered you to stay here and wait for instructions about the Chateau de la Fer.
And what if the musketeers come?
I'm sure you are more than capable of dealing with them. You must hide in the neighborhoods. I suppose I could leave my spare horse for you.
Indeed. Tether can just be on that wood. I can get there through the garden. Send help at the moment.
Anything to please you, milady. I'll take him there at once.
I do, children.
I do about the insides of our seat. Remember me. Save it.
Who was that man, madam?
My brother. He was at an India bottle, and he heard the musketeers, the snuff. He heard the cardinal's guards, fought on that.
What do we do?
We can hide in the neighborhood.
How will D'Artagnan find me?
Every day, my brother can ride
Constance.
I see she has been before us. Are they both dead?
No. Only Constance. D'Artagnan, know who you are. Women weep for the dead. Men adventure.
If we're to adventure,
then I'm with you.
That's your answer.
There will be time for that later. First, we must see this innocent child buried. I have plans to make, and I'll meet you at the inn. The horses can be taken by the servants. Treat her as one of your own. Let the requiem be sung in the chapel this evening.
I feel I should be in charge of the plans from now on. After all, my lady is my sister-in-law.
But my lord, she is my wife.
Help me escape. If you don't, I have friends who will
offend
you.
Chase that servant. I saw her speak to him.
And I forgive you for the murder of my brother, for the corruption of your mother, and for the assassination of the Duke of Buckingham. I am innocent.
Forgive me, my lady, for deceiving you. And in return, I will forgive you for poisoning my beloved. Die in peace.
So is it?
This is so that she knows that we act as judges.
That is in order. And now, let the woman see that I am fulfilling not my profession, but my obligation. May the justice of God be done!
Conspiracy against your sovereign, and conspiracy against your commanding officer.
And who lays these charges, Monsignor? A woman branded by the justice of her country. A woman who married one man in France and another in England, and poisoned her second husband. A woman who both attempted to poison and assassinate.
The woman you speak of?
Milady de Winter.
If Milady de Winter has committed such crimes, she will be punished.
She has been punished. She's dead.
By whose hand?
My friends and I tried her and condemned her to death.
Those who punish without license are assassins under the law. I can tell you now that you too will be tried and condemned to death.
Monsignor, I have a carte blanche.
Signed by the king?
Signed by himself.
It is by my order and for the good of the state that the bearer of this paper has done what has been done. Monsieur, I have taken one carte blanche from you, and I give you another. This is a lieutenant's commission in the Musketeers.
Your Eminence, my life hangs at your disposal, but this is an honor I don't deserve. I have three friends.
Do what you wish with the commission, D'Artagnan. But remember, I give it to you. Rochefort! Rochefort, you have met D'Artagnan, I believe. From this moment, I number him among my friends. Greet each other.
We shall meet again, no doubt.
Whatever you please. Apples, this should be yours.
Oh, D'Artagnan, for Athos, this is far too much. For the Comte de Fleur, far too little. You work hard. You keep it.
How am I enclosed?
Magnificent. But I have come to offer you in your splendid uniform, a lieutenancy in the Musketeers.
Ah, you flatter me, D'Artagnan. But I should have had time to attend to my duties. During our campaign, my Duchess buried my husband. Strong box beckons, and these are my weapon garments.
Aaron, take this. You deserve it by the wisdom of your counsel.
Alas, D'Artagnan, our recent adventures have soured soldiers like me. I shall enter the order of the Jesuits. The soldier's life suits you, my dear fellow. Keep the commission.
They too have refused me.
Give it to me, D'Artagnan.
I will write your name in myself. No one is more deserving than you.
But my friends will be no more. I will have nothing but bitter memories.
D'Artagnan, you are young. Your bitter memories will sweeten in time.